Today I'm going to talk about the use of ethanol and gasoline in cars. Now Henry Ford originally made the Model T to run on either ethanol or to run on gasoline. But in 1927 he came out with the Model A that could only run on gasoline. That was pretty much the end for ethanol. At least until recently, now ethanol is becoming popular again. Today ethanol is making a comeback. The United States makes 62% of the ethanol produced in the world, while Brazil produces 25% of the ethanol made in the world. Now, Brazil uses cars that run on ethanol. 87% of their cars run on ethanol. While in the United States, it's a lot smaller figure, it's only 7% of the cars can run on ethanol. The main ethanol fuel in the United States is called E85. It's a mixture of 85% ethanol and 15% gasoline. Now it has to contain some gasoline because pure ethanol is really hard to start a car when it's cold. So the gasoline helps it start up and run better when it's cold. And as I said, 7% of the cars sold in the United States can use that. They're called flex fuel vehicles. And you can only use them in flex vehicles. You cannot use them in a normal vehicle. They won't run right on E85. Now, if you're not sure with your car, just get your VIN number, call up a dealer. They can tell you if it's a flex fuel or not. If it is a flex fuel vehicle, you can use E85. Now, here in Texas, being an oil state, E85 is not that popular. I was going to do a little shoot at an E85 station, but it was going to take me an hour and a half round trip to even get there where I could find one. But if you live in the farmland, hey, they'll be all over the place because the farmers love E85. They grow the corn, they make a lot of money selling the corn, and the corn's turned into the ethanol, like this.
The corn goes to a refining plant where it's turned into barrels of ethanol.
But the truth of the matter, in the United States, most of that ethanol is used to boost octane in your regular gasoline. If you use regular gas, look at the pump. It'll say, may contain 10% ethanol. Well, I guarantee you most of it has 10% ethanol in it. But if you do have a flex fuel car and you want to run it on E85, here's the pluses and minuses of that. Since ethanol contains about 20% less pure energy than gasoline, you're going to get about 20% worse gas mileage using E85 than you will using gasoline. But ethanol burns cleaner, your car's going to pollute less, and it actually runs better in the engine. It makes the engine run cleaner and actually can last longer. And since a modern E85 car is really complex, it can run on any mixture. You could put one tank of pure gasoline, then later you can mix that with E85. The computers on board are able to make it run perfectly with any mix of alcohol and gasoline in a flex fuel car. I've got customers with them and sometimes they drive them like this. If they're just doing regular city driving, they use gasoline to get a little bit better gas mileage. But if they go on the highway, they want a little more power on a trip, they use the E85 and it runs somewhat smoother and they have a little bit more power. Now, if you live in Brazil, you're not going to have any choice. It's pretty much mandated that you're going to use some type of ethanol gasoline mixture to run your car on. But here in the United States, you got free room. You can pick to use it or pick not to use it. It's your choice, ultimately. And as Henry Ford originally believed, you can make ethanol out of any kind of biomass, so a lot of waste products you could turn into ethanol. If we run out of gasoline, heck, we could switch to ethanol just like that. And remember, if you have any car questions, just visit the Scotty Kilmer channel. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.